Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Engineering Classes. We are continuing with our preparation series on GATE Computer Science, UGC NET Computer Science and Bank Officer Exams. So in today's lecture, we'll study a programming question which appeared in GATE 2017 paper. These questions and the lectures in this preparation series will be helpful to anybody who is preparing for their exams, for their competitive computer science exams, and want a quick revision of their concepts as well as the previous year papers. So starting with our question of today's lecture, the question is, consider the C program fragment below, which is meant to divide x by y using repeated subtractions. The variables x, y, q and r are unsigned integers. The code is that is given to you is, while r is greater than equal to y, r is equal to r minus y and q is equal to q plus 1. So you have to tell that which of the following conditions on the variables x, y, q and r before the execution of this fragment will ensure that the loop terminates in a state satisfying the condition x equal to y multiplied by q plus r. So if you carefully read the question, what information you will gather from this is that we are trying to divide x by y using repeated subtractions. Alright, and what condition must be satisfied? That means what condition, the initial conditions that must be present so as to ensure that the loop, when it terminates, it satisfies this given condition. So what is this actual given condition? If we consider here x as the dividend, y as the divisor, q as the question, and r as the remainder, then you will see that this is actually the equation that relates all four of them. So what we actually say, or the equation that holds between all of them, is dividend is equal to divisor into question plus remainder. All right. So this is the condition that should hold at the end of this while loop. So what are the initial conditions that must be imposed before this loop? So if you see that you have to perform division using repeated subtractions. So you have a particular value, the dividend, which is x here, the divisor, which is y here, question is q and remainder is r. So what this loop is doing, as long as the remainder is greater than or equal to the value of y, that means this statement in itself clearly states that r is initialized to the value of y. Sorry, r must be initialized to a value of x, because inside this loop we are subtracting r, we are subtracting the value of y from r. Okay, so initially if we say we have a dividend of 25, the divisor of 5, so we have to divide 25 by 5, but we have to divide it using repeated subtraction. If we assign r, that is the remainder, equal to 25 and we keep on subtracting 5 from this, and every time we subtract 5 from this 25, if we increment the value of the quotient, okay, we increment quotient by 1 every time 5 is subtracted from 25, then at the end, when this condition becomes false, that means when the remainder becomes smaller than the value of 5, then we'll come to know that how many times actually we have subtracted 5 from 25. So as long as the remainder is greater than the divisor, we are subtracting the value of the divisor from the remainder, which is initialized to dividend, and we are incrementing the value of question. So continuing with this example, since initially r has the value of 25 and we enter into the loop y x is 25, y is 5, and question must be initialized to 0. Why it must be initialized to 0? Because question indirectly, it is counting the number of times the divisor has been subtracted from the remainder. Okay, and by the time remainder becomes smaller than the divisor, we'll get a value in the question that will tell us that this is the number of integral divisions possible by the divisor for this particular dividend. Okay, so all these will become very clear. I check the condition of the while loop. R is greater than equal to y. Yes, 25 is greater than 5. So we enter into the loop and I subtract y from r. So the new value of r becomes 25 minus 5, that is 20, and I increment q by 1. So the new value of q becomes 1. Now I again go into the loop. R is still greater than 5. So I decrement this value of r by 5, it becomes 15, and the value of q is incrementing. So basically, if you try to relate the number of times I am decrementing r by y, I am incrementing the value of q. So q is basically counting the number of times I am decrementing r. Again, 15 is greater than 5, so I move to 10, and here the count or the question becomes 3. Then 5 is still smaller than 10, or 10 is greater than 5. Again, I decrement, and here I increase the value of q by 1. Now 5 is equal to 5. So still I'll decrement this value and increment this value. Okay. So what we are actually doing, we are copying the value of the dividend into the remainder. We are subtracting the value of the divisor from this value that is being copied, and we are counting the total number of subtractions that we can make before the remainder becomes less than the divisor. Okay, so what should be the initial conditions that must hold? What are the conditions that we imposed? We equated, or we made q equal to 0, and we initialized the value of r with x, and we must also ensure that the value of divisor should be greater than 0, because this is the basic rule of division. The divisor should be greater than 0. Alright, so if you see all these four options, C option is the best suitable answer that represents the conditions that you must ensure before the running of this while loop. So this is the initializations and the condition you must check before performing this repeated subtractions to perform the division of x by y. All right. So that is all for today's lecture. I hope you understood this question. Please like this video and share it with your friends. Tell us in the comment section below how did you find it, and to get the notifications of more upcoming videos, please press the bell icon next to the name of our channel. Subscribe to our channel to get more notifications on our upcoming videos. Keep watching, stay tuned. Good luck.